guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh Lord, some of these days I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother howdy when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother hey when I shake mother hand that day. That's when I won't. Oh, that milky white way. Some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yes, I want to meet God the Father.
That rod and the staff for me. It is raised in incorruption. Seen, but everything which I've not seen. Thank you. together here this morning to celebrate the life and the legacy of our beloved sister, Sister Tracy Little. And at this point, the family has outlined the Holy Service for us to preside by it, and we are outlined as we will preside as it is outlined. And first we will have a hymn by Pastor Oakland Todd Bryant, Bethlehem Baptist Church, followed with a prayer by Elder Dean Harden, followed with a selection by Sister Bridget Champion. Then we will have scriptures, Old Testament from Booker T. Jones Jr., New Testament Minister Sarah Dice. Afterward, we will have a family tribute by Sister Linda Morton, followed with a selection by Sister Bridget Champion, and then yours truly will come back with the word of comfort. As you see the name on the program, please just come and do what you are on the program to do. And before we get started, there's limited restroom facility in the foyer area, but if you go through the door on the right or the door on the left and just follow the signs, it will lead you to some bathroom facility down the hall. So at this time, we're going to ask Pastor Quintard Bryant to come for the hymn.
Real quickly, all over the building, can we just clap our hands and celebrate the life of the
Spirit of God, the Holy Ghost, that makes intercession for us. So God, right now, ever in the earth, God, that you have not already been. But God, thank you that you love us enough to never put more on us, God, than we can bear. Because you promised us you was the heavy load shell and the burden bearer. So God, we lay this burden on you right now. We can't do anything with it. We lay it on you, God. But God, even in this, we still say thank you. Because this is the will of God concerning us right now. So God, we say thank you. We say much applause. We appreciate you for letting us have her as long as you need, God. You was not selfish. Because you love us too much to do us wrong. And you are too just, God, to ever make a mistake. No matter how much we love Tracy, you loved her more. And for that, God, we release her to you, God. Because Tracy said amen, Lord Jesus. And so we say amen, Lord of God. We say amen. Amen. Amen.
I only know you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Jesus died and rose again. Now we got to believe.
true friend that was given by God. I have no doubt about it, that she was given to me by God. I had the honor of meeting Tracy over 2 years ago. God aligned us together at the death of my late husband in 2020, who battled cancer 3 times. What I realized more than ever in the past 2 years and weeks, that friendship is a lifeline.
Amen.
When we have an opportunity to connect with like-minded people who genuinely care about you, about one another, not expecting anything in return, they are a gift from God.
Yes.
Friends are those that we can laugh with.
Yes.
They take time to listen to the heart of good and bad times.
Come on.
A true friend holds up a mirror to help to show us our strength when we're weak.
Yes.
Friends point out good characteristic traits like courage and loyalty when we feel lost.
Yes.
Tracy was a friend to me, to many of you sitting before me and her family. As we worked together, attaining our master's degree at Jace Divinity School, she seemed to always know when something was wrong. Tracy would call and say, Linda Mae, see Sarah, she called me Mae. Linda Mae, what's going on? And I looked, and now that's not my name now. My name is Linda Martin. I called her Anna Mae. I don't know where we got these names from, but they just stuck like glue. I remember one day we were back and forth to Charlotte, North Carolina for a leadership program with the Jace Divinity. And I did all the driving. She always pointed me as a driver. I drove everywhere for Tracy. And we got home and I was so tired, and I said, Tracy, I'm gonna take a nap because we had to go back to Charlotte. And she said, okay, I'm gonna watch TV. Well, I went to sleep, I was out. And when I woke up, she said, Anna Mae, she said, did you get some rest? I said, you know what I did? She said, oh, you sure did, you were snoring. I said, now Anna Mae, don't you tell nobody. Now Tracy got me up here today telling everybody that I'm snoring. Hallelujah. Oh, I tell you, but there were times and days when she would ask, how are you doing? And I would say, sis, it was a tough day today. Sometimes she would begin to pray, and other times she would just listen as she was obedient to the move of God. So we got to know when to listen. We got to know when to speak and when to just rush sometimes. And she knew exactly what to do. Tracy went through the pain with me at the death of my husband, being a vessel that stayed ready and willing to give a word. She loved reminding me of God's promise in Deuteronomy 31:6, 31st chapter and 6th verse. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or terrified because of them. For the Lord God goes with you. He will never leave you or forsake you. So I say to you, Curtis, Jasmine, and to the entire family, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or terrified because of them. For the Lord your God goes with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. And in the word of God, it also says in 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter, the 5th verse states, now the one who has fashioned us for this very purpose is God, who has given the Spirit as a deposit, guaranteeing what is to come. So understand this, the reason we are Christians, we can approach death in this manner and eternity with confidence and without fear, is because God has placed the Holy Spirit within us. Within Tracy, the assurance of eternal life comes because God has said it in his word. And the Holy Spirit has confirmed it in yours, minds, and in Tracy's heart. Because we have assurance this is true, this is what births confidence in us. To know that it is to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. So lean on God and remember all the beautiful memories that you all created, while remembering her beautiful smile and affectionate laughter, loved for God's people and life. This poem, I'm going to end with this poem. It just sums it up so beautiful. The name of it is called Life. The author is unknown. Life is just a stepping stone, a pause before we make it home, a simple place to rest and be until we reach eternity. Everyone has a life journey, a path to take with lots to see. God guides our steps along the way, but we never were meant to stay. Our final destination is a place filled with love, his majesty, and grace. Today, we celebrate the life of a loved one who has gone before us the race she has won. Her journey has ended. Her spirit has ascended, claiming the great reward with Jesus our Lord. Thank you.
Know that he's with you forever and ever. And
he said, wherefore would I go to him today? It is neither new moon nor Sabbath. And she said, it shall be well. Then she saddled an ass and said to her servant, drive and go forward. Slight not thy riding for me, except I bid thee. So she went and came unto the man of God to Mount Carmel, and it came to pass when the man of God saw her afar, that he said to Jehazel, his servant, behold, yonder is that Shulamite.
All right.
Run now, I pray thee, to meet her, and say unto her, is it well with thee? Is it well with thy husband? She responded, is it well with the child? And she responded, it is well. I want to talk about the day, family. It's well. It is well. It is well. The message today is about a woman who had a little more than common faith. In this life, we talk about faith, but when our faith is challenged, there are times we need more than just a common faith. When our faith is challenged to the extent that everything that you prayed about, that everything that you desire, seems to be at risk. And we began to ask ourselves a question sometime, Lord, where is you? It is at that time that our faith must be more than a common faith. When I think about the life of Sister Tracy, and those that knew Tracy, knows that Tracy's life and her belief in God and her hope in God were more than common. Tracy had a faith out of this world. There were many times we set out to do things, and I don't care what it was, Tracy always said God can do it. And I want to tell the family today, whatever pressure you're under right now, if you would just trust God, I want you to know God can do it. We find that this woman in this text today, by her words, they was anticipated and seeded far beyond a common faith. We are told that this great woman of God, that she will constrain the prophet with her hospitality. As soon as he will come past the city, he will dwell in a little chamber that her and her husband had built for the man of God. She recognized that it was something about the man that could not be ignored. And I want y'all to understand today that this man, the prophet Elisha, symbolizes Christ. Christ is a man that cannot be ignored. And we must understand today that a lot of stuff is going on in the world because we are ignoring the word of God. And if we would just come back to the word, everybody trying to figure out what's next, what's going on. I never seen anything like this, and I don't know what we're gonna do. I tell you what we're gonna do. We're gonna turn back to God, and we're gonna start back to calling on the name of the Lord. And let me tell you something else. We're gonna do. We're gonna stop playing church, and we're gonna start being the church. Can I get a witness on the hill? Relationship.